हेलो चिल्ड्रन, गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू ऑल। यस्टरडे आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू अबाउट द थ्री डिफरेंट रिवर बेसिन्स ऑफ द नॉर्दर्न प्लेन्स। मीन्स द नॉर्दर्न प्लेन इज अ फ्लैट लैंड सरफेस विच इज लोकेटेड एट द बॉटम ऑफ द नॉर्दर्न माउंटेन्स। इट इज द फर्टाइल लैंड इन आवर कंट्री एंड इट इज डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री डिफरेंट river basins. Basin is an area which is drained by river and its tributaries. The states which come under these river basins are Punjab and Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Uttaranchal, Bihar, West Bengal and Assam. Now, these seven states are divided according to the river basins. Punjab and Haryana come under Satluj basin. Satluj and its tributary being Bias form Satluj basin, in which these two states are located, Punjab and Haryana. Then Ganga basin or Gangetic plain we call. It is the largest among the three. It is drained by Ganga river and its tributaries, branches like Kosi, Gandak, Ghagra, Yamuna, etc. Then comes Brahmaputra river basin. It will be covering Assam and some parts of West Bengal. Understand? This I taught you yesterday. And now I am going to start about the same lesson. Which states come under these river basins and which how they, what are the crops grown there, etc. Regions covered under northern plains, the areas which come under different river basins. In Satluj basin, we are talking about now Satluj basin first. We are talking about Satluj basin. In Satluj basin we get Punjab and Haryana. So we are talking about Punjab now. Understand? What are the crops grown in Punjab? Which are the sightseeing places? How is the climate here? What do the people wear? Everything we are going to learn. Okay. The major rivers flow through Punjab are Satluj, Bias, Ravi. Satluj, Bias and Ravi. Bias and Ravi are the tributaries of Satluj River. They provide water to irrigate the farmlands. These three rivers, Satluj, Bias and Ravi River, they supply water to the fields of Punjab. And here wheat, rice, sugarcane are grown in plenty. Wheat, rice and sugarcane are the main crops of Punjab. Punjab, what is the meaning? Panj means five, ab means rivers. So, Punjab is the land of five rivers. The three main rivers which flow here are Satluj, Ravi and Bias. Not Bees. These rivers provide water to the fields or farms in Punjab. And what are grown here? Wheat, rice and sugar cane. These are the three main crops of this area. Apart from them, you can have vegetables, pulses are also grown, and cattle rearing is also main work here. Chandigarh is the capital of Punjab. It is the planned city. Amritsar is also a big city in Punjab. It is famous for its golden temple. Other big cities are Jalandhar, Ludhiana and Patiala. Chandigarh is the capital of Punjab. Understand? Chandigarh is the capital of Punjab and Haryana also. Now we are talking about the Punjab, so we talk about Chandigarh. Punjab. The capital is Chandigarh. Other important cities are Amritsar, Ludhiana, Jalandhar. Amritsar is a holy place for the Sikhs, Punjabis. It is a place of Guru Nanak Dev. And Amritsar is famous for its golden temple. Understand, what festivals are celebrated in Punjab? Guru Parv, Baisakhi, Holi and Diwali are celebrated in Punjab. Baisakhi is harvest festival. During the month of March or April it will be there. And Guru Parv, now in Kartik Purnami they have Guru Parv, they call it. Holi and Diwali are the important festivals here. Understand? They speak Punjabi and Hindi language. Here people speak Punjabi and Hindi language. Once again I repeat, Punjab is the main state in the Satluj Basin. Its capital is Chandigarh. Main rivers here are Satluj, Ravi and Bias. They supply water to the farms or fields in Punjab. And people here mostly are farmers. They grow wheat, sugar, cane and rice. Understand? And they celebrate the festivals like Baisakhi, Guru Parv, Holi and Diwali. Here people speak Hindi and Punjabi. Main cities are Amritsar, Jalandhar, Ludhiana. Amritsar is famous for its golden temple. Next comes Haryana. In Satluj Basin, next is Haryana. Its capital is also Chandigarh. Chandigarh is the capital of both Punjab and even Haryana. They speak here Haryanvi language. It is the Yamuna and Satluj rivers provide water for irrigation. Yamuna and Satluj river provide water for irrigation here. Same way, wheat, rice, sugarcane are main crops here. Wheat, rice and sugarcane are main crops here. Cattle rearing is also in practice. Means cattle, they keep cattle. And dairy farming is a main occupation of the people here. They speak Hindi and Haryanvi languages. Now Delhi. National capital Delhi. It also comes under Satluj Basin. It is the union territory of India. It is located on the banks of Yamuna River. Understand? It is the capital of India. It is center of administration of the Union Government. It has many famous monuments. Monuments means historical buildings it has. Red Fort, Jama Masjid, Qutub Minar, India Gate, Lotus Temple, Gurudwara, Sisganj, Akshardham Temple, Jantar Mantar, these all are the sightseeing places of this place. Then comes Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh is in Gangetic Plain. It is the thickly populated area. Means all over India, densely populated. Means lot of people, large population of India is found in Uttar Pradesh. Its capital is Lucknow. Lucknow is the capital of Uttar Pradesh. Other important cities are Meerut, Agra, Kanpur, Allahabad and Varanasi. Understand? Meerut, Agra, Kanpur and Varanasi are other important cities of Uttar Pradesh. Here also wheat, rice, sugarcane, pulses, oil, seeds are grown. What crops are grown here? Wheat, rice, sugarcane, pulses and oil seeds are grown here. Understand? Here people speak Hindi. Major festivals celebrated are Holi, Dasara, Diwali, Eid, Muharram and Christmas. All important festivals are celebrated here. Holi, Diwali, Dasara, Eid, Christmas, Muharram, all the festivals are celebrated here. Then comes Bihar. Bihar is the land of great men, Lord Buddha and Mahavira. They took birth in this area. In the state of Bihar. Both Gaya and Nalanda are the places associated with Lord Buddha. Patna is the capital city of Bihar. Rice is the major crop. Rice and jute are grown in Bihar. Wheat, sugarcane and jute are also grown here. Hindi and Urdu are the most important languages spoken here. They celebrate Diwali, Dasara, Durga Puja and such festivals in Bihar. Bihar is also one of the main states in northern plains. Its capital is Patna. It is famous for two important persons, Lord Buddha and Lord Mahavira. Understand? And this place, well known, both Gaya and Nalanda are the two places which are associated, related to Lord Buddha. Here, rice, jute, wheat, sugarcane are grown. And people celebrate here Dasara, Diwali, Durga Puja, etc. Now comes West Bengal. West Bengal is known for its fertile plains formed by the river Ganga and Brahmaputra. Delta, Sundarbans, Delta. Very fertile land, smooth. It is at the mouth of the river, Delta, is formed in West Bengal by the rivers Ganga and Brahmaputra. Kolkata is its capital city. And Durga Puja is the main festival here. And people grow rice here. And music, people are fond of music and painting. They are very artistic people. Very nice people. They are very skillful artists here. Understand? Popular festival celebrated here is Durga Puja. Then, the reason for northern plains having most popular states in the is fertile soil, which is required to increase the farm production. Why you find lot of population in the northern plains? It is only because of the kind of soil it has, fertile soil, which enables the growth of different crops. That's why people live here. And on the banks of the river, most of the industries have come up, sugar factories, iron and steel factories and all are established. Understand? Because of all these reasons, this area has, the northern plains has lot of population, highly populated. Understand? So, but one thing, bad thing is, these factories release their chemical waste into the rivers, which pollute the river and which pollute the climate of the places here. That's why we have to take care that though it is such a nice and beautiful place, it should not be polluted. For that, we have to take care. That's it for today. Lesson is over. Please read this lesson. Tomorrow, I will start with my notes. Thank you.